You go on a first date with someone, what habit or characteristic is a deal breaker? Spending the whole time on their phone. Modified version, they always seem to be on their phone but never reply to you. Had a first date with a guy once. At some point, I asked him to look up something on his phone. I forget exactly what the context was. And he told me he had intentionally left his phone in his car for our date. Color me impressed. We dated for nearly a year. They only want to talk about themselves. I once had a 2-hour blind date. By the end, I knew everything about this girl. I knew all of her cats by name. Asterisk and what their favorite movies were. Asterisk. She asked me literally nothing. And just kept jumping from topic to topic. At the end of the date, she wanted to trade numbers. And I couldn't help but ask, "What's my name?" And she didn't know. So I just paid for my meal and left. I'm sorry. Her cats had favorite movies. I'm imagining you going over to her place and a tabby rubs against your foot. Oh, you must be Matilda, who loves natural-born killers. Good choice. Oh, and is that Randolph? You really couldn't think of anything better than snakes on a plane? Humans getting hurt and dangly noodles to play with. Snakes on a plane is the perfect movie for a cat. Exactly. It's overrated in the cat world. I've seen being rude to waitstaff a dozen times in here. Are that many people rude to waiters? No. Source. M. Waiter. I'd say roughly 1/200th people are actually rude. Especially without reason. Now I do also believe people are generally more rude to a waitress, but that is my experience. I was going to say, where do you work where the ratio is that low? But waiter versus waitress makes sense. Although I hadn't really considered it. Former female server, and I'd say my numbers were more like 1 in 20. That number might be skewed by negative experience taking up memory, though, and most people aren't screaming for the manager rude, but just treating you like you're not a human in general, followed by a poor tip is the average bad customer. And also I forgot to add, male versus female matters tremendously in a restaurant and it breaks my heart. I watch women get torn up by older men who think they can speak that way. A lot of times me, a 6'1", 1,200-pound man, not huge or menacing, but bigger than the kind of people who do this, will walk up and the tone gets changed because they don't think they can bully my like the little 5'5 girl, who I'd be terrified of if it came down to it. You learn a lot in industries that deal with the public. Constantly talking about their exes. I feel like there's a balance needed. For my so and I, we were upfront about weird issues we brought with us from past relationships. Everyone has baggage. You gotta be able to talk about it so your new boo won't be confused when something unimportant to them stresses you out completely. I know there are things that would have really annoyed me. Be you because we talked about our past relationship issues. It was a lot easier to grow past it and be better with one another. Edit. To add some context. Yes, it was our first date. We also live in NYC. So my theory that the city makes everything move at a quicker pace. Even tough conversations about communication and emotional boundaries. On their phone the whole time. If you can't disconnect for an hour or so to engage with me, then it's not going to work. Right? I'm on a date as I'm reading this entire thread and I can't believe how much of it I agree with. This bitch keeps tutting and clearing her throat loudly and I don't know why. Learn some manners. Damn, give her a strepsil or something, she might have a sore throat. They talk over me and spend the conversation giving me unsolicited advice about how to live my life. Edit. I feel like I need to specify that I was thinking of one specific first date that did not become a second date when I answered this. Lol. The guy didn't like that I had dyed my hair blonde at the bottom and spent a lot of the date telling me about the dangers of bleaching your hair and how I should learn to make better choices. I just wanted to have a good dinner, man. Terrible haiku, but what did I expect? Tilde tilde only our first date, tilde tilde. Tilde tilde the asshole speaks over me, tilde tilde. His advice is crap. Actually, this is rubbish. Let me try again. Be quiet, woman. Listen to my genius. For I am strong man. One last time. I'm smarter than you. Do what I say, stupid girl. I cry every night. Too much discussion about money. Not a date, but first time meeting my current GF's friends. The one's first question to me was, so what do you do for a living? How much do you make? Quote, I've never forgotten it and haven't cared for her since that moment. That actually happened to me once and I actually walked out of the date. Towards the end of university, I got drinks with this girl from Tinder. Off the bat, she asked what I did for work, and how much I was making. Quote, prior to this, I was working two part-time jobs, but quit both of them when I began doing really well through my online business. She must have thought I was lying or it was some rinky-dink thing I was doing, despite me explaining in detail what I did in a relatively hostile way. She then asked, do you have any plans with your life? Quote, I politely began explaining some of the jobs I was applying for before she cut me off and said, so, you have no plans with your future is basically what you're saying. Thankfully, I had a $50 bill in my pocket, so I reached in, slapped that sucker on the table, and just said, enjoy the French fries, and walked right out. Lol. Lots of people get nervous on first dates, but blatant hostility and rudeness is unacceptable. Plus, this was a killer confidence booster and reminder that you'll always walk away scot-free, no matter how bad a date is. I love the subtle flex of a $50 bill after she was getting on you for apparently being poor. When she puts her smoke out in her baked potato. LMAO, I'm assuming there's a story behind this. He was still hungry and wanted to finish the baked potato. She done gone and ruined it. Someone who makes me read their bad poetry. This has happened to me more than once. Edit as I just woke up to a bunch of responses and I can't possibly reply to them all individually. I don't hate poetry. I very much like it. Especially vogue and poetry. However, on a first date, there is a huge difference between have you read this poem by X? What do you think of this bit? And here is my notebook. Read it all and tell me what you think. Story bits for those who asked. The first time this happened, I was 18 and we met through mutual friends. While it wasn't great, it wasn't emo angsty levels of bad. Unfortunately, he then started sending me poetry he had written about me and calling me his muse. This after having met once. He then went full stalker. So yeah, nope. Second time was some years later. It was bad, but I was not mean about it. We continued chatting, then said good night politely and parted. The next day he went from I had a really nice time. Give me a call, to I am sure you are busy. But please reply, to clearly you are ignoring me so let's never speak again. In the space of a 3-hour barrage of text messages, I was at work so I didn't see the messages till lunchtime. Have you tried Vogue and poetry? It is out of this world. Greater than, oh freddled grunt buggly. Greater than thy micturations are to me. Greater than as flirtled gabble blotchets on allergic bee. Greater than group, I implore thee, my funding turlingdromes. Greater than and hoopsiously drangle me with crinkly bindle wordles. Greater than or I will run thee in the gobber warts. Greater than with my blurgle crunchin. See if I don't, quote. Edit. Formatting on mobile is hard. Getting so drunk on the first date that you can't figure out Uber and I have to drive you home. No, you can't stay on my couch. I don't know you. I did this once. That relationship ended up lasting 2 years though. Was going to just be a hookup. My first time doing that. So I got drunk to not be nervous. Got too drunk. He took me back to his house and out me in pajamas and fed me pizza and held my hair while I puked. I thought he would never want to see me again, but he was cool about it. I was once set up to go on a blind date with this girl. We were given each other's email addresses and so I hit her up. We exchanged a few pleasantries, then set up a date, time to finally meet. The day of, I get an email from her in the morning with an attachment. I open up the attachment and there is a questionnaire with like 25 to 30 questions on it. She requested I kindly fill out the questionnaire before we meet. I quickly reviewed the questions before sending her a reply saying that it's probably best we don't meet. I don't know what characteristic she embodied, but I'd say that was a deal breaker. What kind of questions were they? I don't recall the exact questions, as it was a long time ago, but I do remember some were as innocuous as dog or cat, but others required further explanation like who is your favorite person in the world? What has he, she done to make you like them so much? Quote, it was insane. I've had job interviews that were less thorough. It kind of sounds like the OKCupid questionnaires. I actually find them useful to read through, if only to weed out the ones who say, yes, I believe the earth is bigger than the sun. Probably wouldn't email that to a prospective partner though. I don't believe in the moon. I think it's the back of the sun. Lying, even, if not especially, about small things. I was once told that someone had gone down a hill on their bike so fast a speed camera clocked them at 234 miles per hour. Ignoring that that's faster than the world record on a bike. Why are you making this up? 234 miles per hour? That's pretty badass, dude. You still have their number? He just told you, 234. If they are hard to talk to, might not make them a bad person. But obviously there is no chemistry if all I get are one-word answers where they also don't reciprocate questions. So you're a teacher, right? Quote, yep. Well, that's cool. What grade? Quote, second. Ah, what a great age. That's like the perfect time cause kids still kind of like school. Quote, uh-huh. Check, please. I still get this with my girlfriend sometimes. I think some people can just be natural listeners. Obviously, it won't be received very well on the first date. AHHA. Zero opinions on anything. If I'm going to date someone, I want some sort of brains or passion going on up there. Shit. This is probably where I will fail the most. Politics? Zero. Religion? Zero. Sports? Nada. Popular TV shows? Probably not. Only have a few passions and am capable of talking about them for hours non-stop if brought up. But other than that, I will only meet the bare minimum, monsieur. It really doesn't matter what it is. People generally like listening someone talk about something they are passionate about. Unless your passion is like murdering hobos or something, you should be fine. I watched a monster eat a Caesar salad with her mouth wide open. It was impressive but absolutely gross. Within 20 minutes of that date, I knew where her vibrator and weed were stored at her parents' place in her room and that she made $240 every 2 weeks. I can smell her through this comment. Yuck. I know a girl who asks every guy she goes on a date with what his credit score is. She wants to make sure they're financially stable. Also, she's 23 and doesn't know how to pump gas. Does she offer anal when it's above 730? Meta. I don't hate people who smoke particularly, but my parents smoked so much that I promised myself to never date someone who smoked. I used to smoke. I have been smoke-free for 3.5 years now. It is amazing how different I smell. And how I never noticed. I don't know how non-smokers put up with being around me smoking all the time. It is extremely hard. Good for you. Being a know-it-all. I had lunch with someone who called the table salt sodium chloride and used the bread as a way to tell me everything he knew about complex carbohydrates, some of which wasn't even correct, and their connections to evolutionary theory. Just felt like he was compensating for something. #SODIUMCHLORIDE. Dude, it's salt. Looks like you couldn't handle the neutron style. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.